If you can imagine a 1.6 million square foot facility that's completely empty, just try to imagine how empty that feels. How do you reinvigorate? How do you re-energize a campus? That's what the challenge of building out the West Campus was. It was Michael Donahue, following the initial work that Andy Hamilton did, where we began to formulate this idea of institutes. Institutes that aren't supporting one department or one school, but rather have science that spans across schools and departments, but also allows the university to move in new research directions that are not represented by any one program.
I set up my lab believing that I could do something to understand human disease. I never fathomed that we would have the technology or the capabilities to see that vision mature in less than 3 years.
Now we have these larger spaces that we can also begin to work on some of the treasures that Yale has that have been in storage. And we've never really had the time or the resources or the people to really look at these and bring some of these things to light.
We had upwards of 80 acres of usable site on which some of those ideas that previously couldn't fit all of a sudden would have a home.
It took people that had incredible commitment to making this happen and a willingness to take a huge risk to be some of the first people on the campus.
The types of labs and the types of investigators that came were beyond my wildest dreams.
The other thing that the institute structure provides is an opportunity for faculty from very different disciplines to converge on a common scientific question.
The important thing for us was to develop a lab that everybody shared, and not just simply in the same building, but in the same room. And what's been great is the kind of collaboration and cross-linking of ideas as we see other people working in the lab.
One of the decisions that we made fairly early on is that we would invest significantly in core instrumentation. So that's been, I think, one of the strengths of the campus, is an effort, for example, led by Jesse Reinhart and others to make proteomics and mass spectroscopy a strength of the West Campus.
We were going to grow a large life science population of labs and institutes, but there was just this feeling that technology was going to be a big part of that. Engineering was going to be a big part of that. Programs have emerged that I am convinced would never have existed anywhere else and allow us to engineer a simple organism like bacteria, but made it incredibly powerful and very, very facile to look at human disease like I think no other lab does in the world, perhaps.
The Isaacs lab works with this genome engineering technique that really no one else knows how to do. So I feel like the collaboration is not just within the institutes, but it's really, you can walk to anyone on this campus and everyone's doing something different and everyone helps each other out.
We bring this distinctive here to the science initiative that's underway at Yale, is that we draw from all the elements of basic science and clinical science and put it together to improve healthcare.
And so this is one place for all of the energy researchers from across Yale to come together. Our students and groups work in one open space, and so there's a high collision frequency. There's lots of conversation happening all the time between material scientists and chemists and physicists, and that enables us to tackle problems in an interdisciplinary way that wouldn't be possible without West Campus.
It's really amazing that you can come here and still be impressed beyond what you thought you would be impressed.
We now have 41 research laboratories and the accompanying postdocs and graduate students distributed across 7 research institutes.
There's a lot more new hires that started out here that are also becoming, you know, more seasoned mentors with bigger labs.
The senior faculty have actually taken a very active role in mentorship and collaboration. They really bring us together and allow the junior faculty to showcase the work that they're doing, and they have us put on a workshop every year that brings scientists from around the world who are solving the energy problem.
We connect with a diverse group of students and faculty across Yale, and it acts as a workshop, it acts as a classroom, it also just acts as a wonderful gathering space where people can have conversations in a different way.
There's been a tremendous interest in both the research labs and the conservation lab, that students actually are becoming interested in conservation. And so some of my students are now gone on to be conservators, which I'm quite pleased about.
I think if you look around today, the West Campus is showing you what can be done in a short period of time with a lot of commitment, investment, and hard work.
The next step for the West Campus is to make this a mature research endeavor that is able to move the needle of how good science at Yale is.
It's a tremendously exciting opportunity for Yale. It's not just a place for growth for the university overall, but it's a place for Yale to identify the big problems where it wants to create these institutes.
Over the next 5 or 10 years, I want to diversify even more who we're working with, what we're accomplishing, and the big problems in the world that we're trying to solve.
I think there's tremendous opportunity for growth from here. Nursing is a STEM science. It's also a STEAM science. We know that that work is growing right here on West Campus, where we have these wonderful centers, institutes, a school, and opportunities to take that even to the next level.
Oh, they need to get out here to just visit. Even if you're not doing research out here, there's something here for everybody.
I really have a very optimistic and very grand vision of the future of the West Campus. There's so much room to grow up and out. I don't think we should stop. I think that we've just begun to see what can be realized on the campus research-wise, and I think the more the better.